Welcome, welcome, welcome to Europa Park, where it's day one of our first ever time visiting this park. There's lots to explore, including the new Voltron. So hit like, hit subscribe, and join us as we investigate.
Something to see.
It's crazy, isn't it? It's very overwhelming because there's so much everywhere we go. It's a ride or theming, just constant.
We didn't know there was a ride in the Epcot-esque ball.
Should we go do it?
Yeah.
You had no idea. You're quite blind about this park. You don't really know what's here, do you? Which
other
is exciting.
Other than the bigger coasters, and I knew the areas were all countries in Europe, but that's about it. So.
I am so excited for you to see, but we're in France now.
Yeah.
We've got the blank coaster. I don't want to say what it is to ruin it.
Oh, is this the Can-Can one?
There you go. Oh, no. And also Silver Star the Hyper, so let's go get on them, I think.
Don't know why we're being so foolish, not just heading to the back. We checked out the Can-Can coaster and Silver Star, and they're both on 40 minutes already, which makes sense because they're by the front of the park. Our top tip always is head to the back. Make your way forward, because everyone goes to the first thing they see. And us being excited, we're like, let's get straight on this. No. We're going to head to the back. We think Henry's got a fast pass sort of thing that you can get a virtual queue for Wodan. New glasses, by the way. So we're going to go head towards Iceland. That's the tip we've been given. I don't know why we've ignored it. Let's go do that instead.
Abyssus. That definitely wasn't called Abyssus.
Nope.
It began with an A.
Atlantis. Let me check my log read. That was Abenteur Atlantis.
Yeah.
How did you find your interactive dark ride
that was and really fun. Atlantis? Really fun. I think we're already quite wild by the park, and then we got on the queue line, and there's like an animatronic in the queue line for a ride that has like a 5-minute queue.
Oh, it wasn't even that.
It was walk on.
Yeah. And we walked straight on, and there's just a cast member watching. You just put yourselves in the seats, and it closes, and you just went on, and there's no hassle, no fuss, super easy. England could never do that.
We were on the way to a coaster and we saw it was 5 minutes and we just thought we should probably just jump on something rather than walking around forever. And it was fun, really good. And there's a spoiler, it's not a Trommel tunnel, it's like a little tunnel with stars, LED lights, and it's spinning as well as a shooting interactive ride. And it spins you a bit faster in that bit, and that was good.
Yeah, I found that it was spinning me certain ways, but then with the lever, you could decide which way you went.
Yeah.
Kind of imagine like Buzz Lightyear's Ranger spin thing at the Magic Kingdom parks. It was very much like that.
Yeah. And I won.
You did win, I know, by a good amount.
I had no excuse. Because I had Dan spinning me around, but you were probably multitasking spinning yourself and shooting.
Yeah, we'll say that.
Yeah. That was really fun. It was, it reminded me as we came into the brakes for the station of the first time I did Ride Happiness, like, wow, that was fun. Which I think you were saying, we came up and you were like, that is a fun ride.
Yes, that's what I want.
Yeah, because we immediately, like, cross-related, compared this and the Hyperion. And I think they're both really good, but they're so different. Hyperion is about the sheer size and speed and scale. This is about fun elements and a nice long theme ride. So it's so fun. I think the spoiler shaky bit of track before the first Beyond Vertical launch, that's one of my best bits because it's just so wacky.
Yep.
And unnecessary, but it's just so nice to see something like that. It's different.
I loved how the turntable was themed. That then gave us a swing launch into the rest of the ride. I love the multiple launches, which just keep the momentum going. Every time I've looked at it, I felt like these Stryker trains look like Smiler trains, very small, compact, lots of twists and turns. And this feels like a better version of the Smiler. It's not compact, but it's got everything that I'd want from the Smiler, but it doesn't hurt. I was rattly on the wing seat, which was good. It was very exposed, but you guys didn't have a rattle in the centre.
No,
so that's interesting.
Were we on the second row?
Yeah, second row.
Second row in the centre, and it was so smooth. And I've seen like loads of people say it's a bit rattly, and then the comments of it's a bit more rattly if you do certain trains, and then the wing seat over the edge. So, yeah, we'll just means we have to rewrite it and try more.
Oh, multiple. It's definitely up there for me. It's not top, but it's definitely up there. I love fun, themed experiences, and this was great. At the moment, I prefer this to Hyperia on a first ride basis.
I think, both very different, but the overall package of this, I think, is super.
Yeah, if this had a stall, then I'd be all into it. I say that first launch is kind of stally.
Yeah, I guess.
I'm not held for as long, but it's that kind of idea, isn't it, I guess?
Yeah.
But
the top part after the swing launch, that's fun. That's that feels like quite a... A high thrill bit of the ride.
Also operations.
Oh my God.
So double-sided lockers, super
so
easy
fast.
To use. We were straight up into the station. You've got the scrolling platform as well. Scrolling?
Yeah.
Moving platform. So it's like row at a time, just constant getting trains through and out. This eats people to no end.
We did
this
wonder though, in that main hallway before the lockers, there's a big area in the middle with some like tubing for wires. What's meant to be there? Is it where the car was when it opened?
Or... No idea. I cannot remember for the life of me.
No.
I can feel my neck burning though, so that's not good.
Yeah.
We need to find sun cream.
Maybe not at the park, because they had some in there, but it was €8 Woo! For a small bottle.
I had a Powerade for €4.50, which is extortionate.
The merch looks good. So we'll have to check it out.
Yeah. Otherwise, this is, top. This was worth the trip alone. And there's still a whole horde of other rides to check out.
Dan,
so.
What do you think? It's better than Hyperion. Come in the frame.
I'm very sweaty.
Same.
But
it's
I'm
better than Hyperion.
I mean, you're quite a critic, aren't you, really? So it's your second favourite after Ride Happiness.
Yeah.
Hyperia's too short.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You queue for so long, it's too short. Whereas on this, you queue for 40, 50 minutes. I mean, we did, but you queue for 40, 50 minutes and you're on it for 2 minutes.
It's good. What's your favourite bit?
I don't know, all of it's good.
So the boys have just grabbed a
beer.
Oh, let's get out of the way. And I need water. I can't really find many water fountains, surprisingly. Maybe we're just unlocked in the right places, but... When these guys got a drink, I was saying, oh, is there any, can I get some water? And I was like, is there a water fountain? And she was like, oh, no, not sure, not really. And then she was saying about the tap water, but she didn't like it. And I was like, oh, is it not tasting nice? She went, oh, it made me a bit. I was like, oh, like, feel funny. She was like, yeah. I was like, oh. And she went, oh, I've got an idea. And then she opened up a bottle of water and just poured it into my jug. And I was like, oh, is, and she said, oh, it's for me. Like, it's staff. And I was like, right, okay. And we were just saying, that's so nice. Such a little thing for her to do. She could have very easily... just charged me for some water, but no, she just, nothing to her, but I meant everything to me. So now I've got some nice clean water to keep me hydrated on this really, really, really hot day. And yeah, we love it here so far. I mean, we've done two rides in 2 hours, maybe. We got here at 10:30, a bit later than we planned. Yeah, it's 12 o'clock, so an hour and a half, we've done two rides, but we're just soaking it in. This is wonderful. Everything's been superb so far. Oh, also, I cut too soon. We said, have you been on Voltron? And she said, no, not yet, it's too scary. She said, I've been on Silver Star twice. I went on it, I thought I would die. And it was just so blunt, and the accent was just the funniest.
Before we went on that, you were like, what are the towers for? And I was saying, oh, well, you'll find out. And now you know it's for the longest and best lift hill in the world.
That was really fun. It's so random. And, like, the centre bit, until a few circles before, like, you... a few revolutions before you, like, exit the tower. That's the only time that you start to see the theming. Until that, it's just like corrugated metal.
Yeah.
And I was like, this just is weird.
Disco vibes, isn't it? I actually, you know what, if the music wasn't on that bit, it would be so much more boring, but it was really fun actually, just for
there's
that.
Disco lights.
And
I thought Can-Can Coaster was the one with a spiral lift hill. Do both of them have a lift?
I think Can-Can might do as well, actually. Which we'll find out. That's quite intense at the end as well.
Yeah.
That helix right at the end before you go into the brake run.
The first parts feel very monorail-esque.
Yeah.
And I think it's fun to see yourselves in the mirrored walls and you're like, ah, it's us! And then after that, it's intense.
Surprising, was it? Not very comfy for me because the bag's on ride, so my big bag was in the way of my legs.
It wasn't too bad.
Yeah, I should get a different bag, thanks.
Like, LSM Fuse.
Some.
He sold me the pink design bag.
Wow, he should work for them and have a referral link.
I think he does have a referral card.
Do you use it?
No.
What are you picking, Henno?
Okay, let's rock it, right? All right.
Here we
Come
go.
Come on, clap your hands.
Mobile karaoke machine. Yeah. Henry's lost the room key. That's problem number one.
It's because Voltron uses keys for the lockers and I just gave them back.
You dumped it in a bin with like hundreds of other white cards that we need.
Yeah.
Hooray! Anyway, you can deal with that later. For now, what were your thoughts on Pirates? While Stan waits in the background.
Really nice. So much detail. I think like almost too much to take in that you probably you want to re-ride in the same way that I think we go and curse and see new bits. That's like double that.
Oh,
like,
more than
so,
that.
So
it was
much
so
to see.
Detailed. It was
loads
crazy.
Of cool animatronics, loads of good smells, and then you finish through a real restaurant.
Yeah, just like Pirates of the Caribbean, fancy that. The Pirates of the Caribbean must have copied this.
Yeah. I think Dan was saying, like, what's the story? What happened? And I kind of agree. I'm not too sure. Maybe the commentary in German would help if we understood.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, because there was constant commentary, but we didn't know what it was saying.
But still fun, even if you don't know what the story is.
Beautifully detailed, really enjoyed that. I thought it was lovely stuff.
And you don't get wet. I thought maybe there'd be, like, a drop or some bigger water effects. There's some misty bits, but that's about it.
Oh, the projection mapping on the rooms at the end, the sort of shadows that were projected as well onto the sort of sails from the sunken ship, and then also on the water that was dropping down. Yeah. Beautiful stuff.
Very well presented.
Yeah,
as,
I want
as
this.
Is the rest of the park.
I want this in the UK and also in my back garden, please.
Yeah.
Lovely.
Nice. What next? Probably Wodan.
Yeah, we think it's time for our virtual queue. Oh, belt.
Been waiting a very long time to ride this massive GTI. It's basically bigger Wicker Man. That's Wodan in the Iceland area.
I thought it was really good.
Yeah.
I really liked it.
Solid.
I might have overhyped it slightly.
I'm exactly the same. I was waiting to see what you were going to say.
Yeah, I could tell you were like, what's he going to say? Yeah. It was good.
Yeah.
I definitely have a special place in my heart for Wicker Man, yeah. Just the theming and the story and stuff. There's no story here, the theming is superb. We missed the queue line, so maybe there is a story to be fair, because we had a virtual queue for it. But like the Outer Banks, the Airtime Hills, I think with Wicker Man being so compact, there's something in the tightness of the turns and the drops and stuff, and I think that's what I like about Wicker Man, that sort of...
Whippy.
Yeah, whippy's definitely word.
And we were at the front of the train, so maybe a further
back. Yeah, later in the day probably as well. Better. Yeah, I think you're probably right on that.
Still a very good coaster.
Oh, massively, yeah.
But I agree, I think I've heard a lot of good stuff that I maybe expected a little bit more.
Yeah, I think like that first drop's great.
Yeah.
But also, I'm thinking of Wicker Man's like sort of second drop where you instantly turn and it's so sharp, you turn and then turn again. And that just whips you, and when that's like end of the day, when it's super hot, it's just like pew, flying. Yeah. But that was still tremendous. Yeah,
we've got the Mack product storage bins, even though it's a GCI.
Yeah, which was quite cool.
It's a hybrid.
It's a very bit of a nerd thing on our end, but we like that. But the Iceland area is beautiful. I think a lot of people say that this is their favorite area, and looking around and when we walk through, I would have to agree, it's up there. It's gorgeous. However, there's a Mack ride mega coaster next door, which I think we need to go on now. Let's do it.
Yeah, fun.
Front row?
We did the front row queue, and it wasn't that much longer than the main one. It added maybe like 10 more minutes, but not too bad.
I think it was worth doing for the views and stuff, which I really appreciated.
Yeah.
I think back will be better on that.
I agree, but I still don't think it'll be that much whippier, whereas I reckon Wodan will if you do back row.
Yeah, true.
Because that just felt like a nice layout, but not a fast one at any particular point.
Yeah, I get that. I think that was better than Icon, though. Okay, hear me out. We've not spoken about this yet off camera, you see, so this is why we're deciding now. I think Icon's inline roll and the second launch into the top part, and that first top part, thing are better standout elements, but I think that was better overall.
Yeah, I think it's a solid coaster. No one element stands out. If you had to push, it'd be the last inversion, which feels really like quite tight and
that was great, whippy. That was really good, that one.
I think they're both good in different ways.
I think that was smoother than Icon.
Smoother,
Icon's a bit jankier, I think, in parts.
I like the pre-launch like kind of show scenes, they're fun.
Chemical fire or something, or a blue fire, I thought it was really good actually, I rate that.
Yeah.
I think that might be the first launch coaster they did, actually.
Probably.
Yeah.
Because it's a single launch, Icon's multi.
Yep, everything else is after that, isn't it?
Yeah.
Probably. Ride to Happiness, etc.
Yeah, look how many launches Voltron has.
Whoa.
Tons of them.
300.
Fun, good stuff.
Yeah, like
your
that.
Train had a camera, ours didn't.
Yeah, so you could see me on it. However, I didn't buy it, the quality wasn't that good, and I've got a POV anyway, so.
Yeah.
Woo!
Fun?
Iceland.
Get food?
Let's go eat.
Cold refreshments.
I'm hungry. Two more rides on Voltron.
Yeah. Done like a diagonal. I did row 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4.
Yeah, so we had third row as our second ride, and the third ride was on the back. Yeah. I thought the back was best.
Yeah, for the
hang time. Because we mentioned before about there being sort of like two stally type things, and like, yeah, you definitely felt them at the back, which was good. Mm. Dan got an NC and hated it, didn't you?
Horrible. It's worse than Hyperion.
Found it quite rough, and you thought the side was rough as well, but not as bad.
It's definitely rougher than the middle, but not as rough as people like Dan and other enthusiasts online will claim. Like, it's just...
Horrible.
It's not horrible. It is more rough.
Feels like you're driving over gravel.
No, it's definitely noticeable, but it's still enjoyable, I thought. That's my summary.
I didn't like it at all.
But I wonder, is it personal taste? Is it the train?
It
is it actually
so much
the seat?
My GoPro went.
Yeah, that's definitely a point of it.
I do think personal taste probably comes into it a bit, because I was like, whoa, this is cool, scary, rough. But I could see it would be uncomfortable.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think if you want a thrilling yet comfortable ride, middle seat is the way to go.
Yeah, the guy next to me on one of the rides was saying the same thing.
Yeah.
One of the single riders we had. Operations in there are so good, though.
So good.
I like how it's just row by row by row by row by row. It's not done by train in a way, it's just row, 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 row.
Second and third goes, we heard the coils making the little music.
Yeah, which ties in with the sort of pre-show out here with the animatronics, which we saw a bit of before but didn't film, so. Yeah, I think it's still my favourite in the park so far. However, we're going to backtrack somewhat to the start of the day where we tried to do France.
Yeah.
Can-Can and Silver Star.
Ooh la la.
Ooh la la, bonjour, madame.
Oui. Unfortunately, I lied. I didn't mean to. Basically, this park has so many rides just tucked away with little doors, and it's never obvious that it's a ride, that we went past this Madame Dragon Curiosity thing. Not dragon, dinosaurs. Yeah, bit dated, bit old with the scenery and stuff, but there's lots going on. Again, very detailed. I'm noticing that about this park. Very detailed, which I appreciate. However, it was nice to get out of the hotness of today. Dan's being silly, so I'm aware that we should probably get a move on now and actually, maybe now this time, go on one of these roller coasters around here in France. If I had a pound for... This is funny, I've been thinking about this when we got off. If I had a pound for every time I've done a spiral lift hill today at Europa, I'd have £2. Yeah. It's not much, but it's weird that it's happened twice.
Yeah.
So the huge golf ball, aka Spaceship Earth, from Epcot, is really hot and it's really fun. I love that.
It's good.
Yeah. You like it?
Yeah. I'm really confused where they fit.
Oh,
yeah,
sorry.
From the outside, it does not look like you could fit a coaster in there, let alone the lift hill.
I'm surprised that it was all fit in there. And for a while, we were just turning to one side and I thought, don't tell me the whole coaster's going to be based just turning to the right, and then it switched up towards the end and I was like, oh thank god, but yeah. I thought it was really fun, pops of air time, like banking and stuff. I just thought it was really cool. I really like that.
And it was quite like just a lot of turns at first. I was like, oh, this is fun. And then eventually there was a bit more of a this is fun.
Right towards the end, some forces really kicked in. There was like a little so mini bunny hills right at the end. The lights were cool, the audio was cool, the women's legs.
You go through the Notre Dame, legs.
Loads of women's legs for you guys. Yeah, it was good. I thought it was really fun and I would 100% want to re-ride that.
Yeah.
Can we?
Yeah.
Not now. Later. Another day, maybe.
Yeah.
But yeah, love that. Really cool. Right, now we need to go get on Silver Star.
Yes, what did you think of Silver Star?
It was good. I feel like it's forgettable.
Yeah, there's not much to it. Yeah, I mean, okay, sort of old school hyper layouts are very much just out and back, up and down, but I thought Mako was more fun than that.
Dan says he'd take Silver Star over Hyperia. I think that is slander and would take Hyperia over that any day.
Yep, 100%.
I think when this was introduced, it's probably a good coaster, like high up on people's lists, but the elements, like Dan said, it's just a lot of hills and they're fun. It's a lot of airtime. But there's a lot of trims on that. I'm sure. There's a lot of trims on that.
Yeah, there's one right on the top. I noticed it and I was like...
So,
in the dark.
I take the sort of crazier elements of Hyperia, even though it is short, over that.
Yeah, I agree. I'm glad we agree for once.
We always agree.
No, I'm just being silly.
Fun, but forgettable in an all right way. Like, if you come here, definitely do it. But I'm not going to rush to re-ride that as much as I am.
I agree. I would rather do
the
Can-Can
stuff
again. You know what? I would rather try this thing over here. Oh, my days. This is the VR attraction that is the same coaster as the Can-Can coaster we just did. Except you wear VR goggles.
No, apparently it's really good. You get fitted your headset before you ride and then you're guided through and you sit whilst you're already headseted on.
Yeah, I'm really intrigued by that. Should we look at it now and just see what the thing is?
Just to follow up on the VR coaster, you're basically booking a slot, like an hour time slot, and then you turn up at that point, and that's it. Don't know what else to do with that, because we can't book on now, so we'll have to return tomorrow, which is good, because we've got two more days, maybe three, maybe two. We're not decided yet, but we're definitely back tomorrow, so we'll come do it tomorrow. Just had another ride there on Voltron Nevada, whatever it's called. That was my favourite ride on it. We're on the front row, which, that's it, sponsored by that car thing, which is stupid.
Sponsored by Voltron.
That one, Rimac Nevera, I don't know. Anyway, fourth ride, I thought that was my favourite ride on it. We're on the front row. We could see everything. We got like loads of hang time because we were stalling on those bits. And it was great. I didn't have a rattle. It was smooth. It was wonderful. It is. That was cool. Is it my number one coaster? I don't know, but it's close. It's, I got a lot of thinking to do tonight. and more re-rides tomorrow. However, we've got a virtual queue for Wodan. So we're making our way back to Iceland so we can get on that fantastic GCI Woody and get some more thoughts on that in the process. There it goes, glad we did Wodan again. It was thundering round. I think thundering is the only applicable word here for this massive wooden coaster. Wicker Man, as we've said many times, if you've seen various vlogs, even from the other week when we did the very privileged ERT, Dan's trying to burn something on the floor with that magnifying glass. It was thundering around at the end of the night. I say thundering. It was quick. I feel like thundering has to be with this because of the roar of it. It's just very menacing, isn't it, that sound? It's, oh, yeah, really enjoyed that. It's not my favorite in the park. Voltron does take that, but yeah, superb. However, I think that's kind of our day done. So we'll head to the exit and wrap up there. And that's our day one done here at Europa Park in Rust in Germany, in Europe. Yeah, it's really good, isn't it?
Yes, a lovely park.
There's so much I want to say and I can't think right now. It's been a long day, but what, stop it. But I'm glad it's day one. It's definitely a 2-day park, maybe 3 days. We're not sure yet. But it's fantastic. Voltron is fantastic. There's so many rides on offer. You've got your big thrill coasters, the little coasters, the hidden dark rides, just a little door that you enter and then there's another ride. There's so much to see and do. It's mad.
Yeah,
it's,
there's no stopping. You're going constant, and there's things to look at. Beautiful scenery, plants, flowers, just
everything.
Absolutely lovely. Then there'll be a coaster and then there'll be a little dark indoor ride.
It's good. It feels like Disney without the Disney IPs. Yeah. I feel like that's the best way to describe it in a way.
Outside of your Disney's and Universals, I think there's only this and one other park that I'd say you need more than one day for sure in.
Is that going to be Efteling or Fantasyland?
Efteling, yeah.
Okay. But yeah, this has been superb. I would normally say case closed, but it's not quite closed, is it? We've purposely not gone to another area of the park, like the other half. We never really ended up there, did we? And then we thought, actually, let's not walk that way. Let's walk back the way we came to ensure we've got a whole new area to look at. So tomorrow will be lots of fresh new stuff to look at. People want to get photos of the fountain, so we're going to go. I am Detective Miracle. That's Detective Cooks and Detective Closes over there. Case almost closed. We'll see you tomorrow.
Case paused.
Paused, yeah.